And a 10-year-old Cecil County girl who was reported missing yesterday has been found dead.
And tonight, state police say they are following a number of leads. 11 News reporter George Lettis is live in Perryville with more details on the investigation. Good evening, George.
Kate and Rob, good evening. Some of the girl's relatives tell me they thought she would be safe when they agreed to let her stay over what police describe as the girl's grandparents. But it was the grandparents' house where the girl was found dead. And tonight we've learned that a person of interest is in police custody. State police say the body of 10-year-old Cammie Ring was found Monday night in a field roughly 60 yards from her grandparents' house in Port Deposit. Police say she was staying there for the weekend and was last seen going to bed Sunday night. It wasn't until 11 a.m. Monday that she was reported missing.
It does sound very unusual to the investigators. The 911 call came from one of the residents who were living at that house.
Police say three people live in the house, the grandparents and a man described as an uncle. All of them were questioned. Sources say the uncle is a person of interest and is in police custody.
And with all the information that I've gotten, it had to have been an inside job.
Ricky Dean was Cammie's stepfather, who says he and her mother taught her to scream if somebody was trying to kidnap her.
Whoever it was, she had trust in that person.
Homicide detectives were back on the scene Tuesday collecting evidence. They will pay close attention to the room where Cammie was sleeping.
Police believe the window just appeared to be open about 7 inches. The screen was popped out.
And that information about the window is why the stepfather believes that whoever did this tried to make it look like a random abduction attempt. Now, police have not released the name of that person of interest. No one has been charged tonight, and authorities are waiting on autopsy results. So right now, the cause of death of the girl is unknown. We're live in Cecil County. George Lettis, WBAL-TV 11 News.
Thank you, George.